Hi Queens, today I'm going to show my Pooja Ghar and how I've organized it. So many of you would be wondering that is this a Pooja Ghar or a wardrobe or some kind of artifact. But yes, I have designed it in a different way. So I had given this design to my carpenter who had done a very good job. I would also get into the technical aspects. But first I'll just give you an overview. So here on the topmost part you can see the dome. So I've given three layers for that, and I'll also tell you the reason why. And now I'm just going to open the door of Pooja and show it to you. Okay, so this is the top part. And you can see the flashlights on, and you can see all the idols and the photos of the frames, and also down below there are four drawers of different heights, and below is the skirting, and this is a removable Pooja so that when I shift probably I can carry it. And this was designed in white because my husband loves white and he also loves to do Pooja, so that is the reason why I gave the carpenter a white Pooja house. Though he told me that this wouldn't work out and you can't maintain, but I clearly told him that you know, the design and specifications I would help, so just do it and give it to me. And it came out really well. This took me the longest time to design for my house. And to let you know, I have designed all the interiors for my house, and choosing the laminates, designs, the size of the cupboard, everything has been designed by me only, and it has been very well executed by the carpenter whom I had outsourced. And here you can see some idols. Then there is a granite slab. This is a grey and a black granite slab. And you can also see all these are layered here. Actually, I keep them in a box and just put it for cleaning. And I thought I would take the video today as I had cleaned the Pooja house today. And you can see I've kept these in a particular synchronized way. You can see the brown ones in the middle, and you can see the golden ones on the side. This Shankaracharya ji didn't have a golden frame. We just got a photo, and my husband is really devoted. So I thought that this particular order would give a good look, brown in the middle and golden. So we already had the Sai Baba in golden, and this is another god, Panchi Kamakshi, and this is Ashtalakshmi, and Venkata Chalapati, which my parents gifted me for the graduation. These two they had gifted, so this is my favorite one as of now. And down you can see all the small idols, and this is Goddess Meenakshi from Madurai, my another favorite god. So I just draped her in sari today. So this is a small DIY which I did, and Saraswati is there, and these are some of the Pooja samans which we use it. So I've just kept it on the top. And I would just show you the drawers, how I've organized them. This is the last drawer, so where we have all the Pooja books. I would tell you about this big book, and there are a lot of books. Actually, we are Telugus, my husband is from Andhra, so there are a lot of books which you can see below also. And I've just kept some Chandan Malas here. So to tell you about this book, okay, so this is also in Telugu only. I don't know to read Telugu. My husband reads it and my in-laws. So this gives a detailed procedure of how to do any puja according to the customs of our house. So if anyone knows Telugu can read it. I don't know what's written here. And these are my husband's grandparents' parents or grandparents. I'm not sure. I believe grandparents' parents. So this is a lovely book. Probably if I learn Telugu, it would be great. And on top of this, these are the right two drawers. So because we are righties, I use the majorly used ones on the right. So here you can see the matchbox, and below also there's so many matchboxes. We buy in bulk and keep. And these are some of his rings and miscellaneous items. Then here you can see the agarbattis and some books which he uses it daily. And these are the puja saman, das items, and diyas which we do every day. And he uses this copper glass for doing Sandhya Vandana. He does most of the days. So I'm more spiritual and he's more devotional. That's how I can say. And this drawer has some of the decorative items, like for Varalakshmi Nombu we use the jada for Goddess Lakshmi. My daughter is learning Kuchipudi, so her chalangai and some of the miscellaneous, some gifting purpose items if suddenly someone comes home, so for that. Then some old picture frames of gods, which we really don't use it now, but we can't give it away anywhere. So this is the last drawer. And so here I have some trays. This I often use, so I've just kept it this way. And these are some cookie boxes in which I've kept all the haldi kumkum, the bangles for all the ladies who come in home. So this is all that stuff. And this is a very big brass velaka, we say. So these are in three parts now. So probably at the end of the video I'll try to show it to you. And these are, okay, I'll let you know what. So whenever we get our silk sari stitched, you would be having some materials left out. You can always ask the tailor to give it to you. And you can make lovely, beautiful dresses for the gods' idols, which are very tiny ones. You can do a DIY. Probably I'll try to do that. And also I have the trays below. I don't know if you guys can see that. Yeah, so these are some of the trays which we use only for puja. I'll just keep this in, trying to be organized now, at least for a day or two. So this is my puja house, guys. I hope you like the tour. Okay, and now the technical part. So this, which you can see, the carved part is not good. It's called CNC board. Okay, so probably they are the compressed wood particles board. And if you give any design, they would feed it into the computer. And it's fully machine cutting. It's not hand cut, it's machine cutting only. And if you keep just this, you're dead, because you can't clean it at all. Just imagine all these grooves and you cleaning them. It's highly tedious, highly not recommended. So there are a lot of people who do the CNC cutting work and jali work. So that's pretty in. And this is 2 years old. I did 2 years back. So what I did was, I gave the carpenter an idea and I told him to give glass on both the sides, so front and back, so that I don't have to clean the grooves. I just have to clean the glass one, and also My husband said that he wants a door. I wanted an open puja, but he wanted a door. So I thought that this would probably be the best thing for both of us, because his path is also done, mine is also done, because it's half see-through. And since the glass is there, it's actually really good to maintain. I didn't use tempered glass because it will make the dough very, very heavy, and I had to go in for teak wood. So that was coming out more than a lakh or so. So this puja house came somewhere roughly around 35,000, I guess. So worth it, because there's so much of work. As you can see, that the beautiful CNC, there's no crack or no kind of breakage, and you can see the detailing. It's really good, and it's exactly the same if you see. And so that's why I loved it, and I thought that 35 would be really good. And on the top, actually, you can see the doom. It's really good because the positive energy gets attracted. So that's the reason why they used to do the Kumbhabhi Shegam and all those things. And these are the three layers. So you're supposed to keep them. That's how it's traditionally done. So what this guy did was, see, this is a whole plywood, okay, which we got it cut. And these are not the separate frames. The ply is being cut from the middle, okay. And the CNC and the glass is attached in front and back. You can see here inside they've given like this. So if you can see, they would have given it here and there so that the glass stands. And in the front part, they have actually inserted the glass, if you can see, inside the groove. Yeah, and they've used something called silica gel. So these are the technical aspects if you guys are looking for that. And what else? And there is a skirting below. So I keep one of the stools out because my husband uses it almost every day. And there's another stool if you open the skirting. Actually, you can open all the skirtings, so just to clean it, because if you do that, it's really good, because it'll be clean. Otherwise, if you take it and see, it'll be really horrible down there. So I've kept another stool required for the puja timings inside. And I guess I'm done with it. Okay, here is a lock, and I love the handles actually, because this design I feel is both modern and traditional in its own ways. And I've not seen a Pooja Ghar in white. I told very clearly to my carpenter that I don't want those brown ones with the bells hanging, which I don't like actually, because everyone has the same, and I like something to be unique. I don't like the same monotonous thing which everyone does. So this is my take on the Pooja Ghar. Thanks to my husband, who likes white color. So because of whom, I could design a different Pooja Ghar, and I could wear my creative hat and think for it. So one side you can see is attached to the wall. And the guy asked me that, do you want it here also? I said yes, of course. For the reason that, obviously, for synchronized look, and also probably if I suppose shift my house, I can also remove them. Now you might be wondering how. Okay, so here if you see, you can see a small white gap here, here, and the photo frames have covered the other two. So basically these are the places where they have drilled and attached to the wall. So, and these are the caps which cover. You get these in hardware shops, and you can ask in the hardware shop for covering the nails and screws. So you can also use it in any other place where you don't want the screws to be shown. It just goes and gets fixed on the head, so that way it looks very neat. You can't actually see it from very far, Once I told you, you can notice that, but no one has noticed actually. Yeah, so these are the technical things, and two flashlights on top, so that gives a really nice look, and it's easy to clean, and also the dome is removable, so if I want in future I can remove it also. And also for the fact that the light wires go from there, and I'll show you where they are, so back there, so it's not quite visible, and I've used those transparent wires, so it doesn't look that bad. You know, don't use those black wires, they look really bad. So the connection comes from there to here, and the plank is right over that. So if you remove the plank and the light gets fused or doesn't work, you can change the new one. So this was the idea which I gave him. I told him please don't fix it because it will get difficult for us to change. And also I got these lights because I got to know later that you can just screw these lights and you don't need to remove the dome really. So that is an update again for you. So I believe I've covered everything, and especially about the granite, I just love it because it really goes with this. It's not black. I told him I don't want black or the brown or the red ones, which I find everywhere. So I wanted something unique and different, which probably many of them don't choose. So that's how I always do. If you had seen my kitchen tour video also, you can find that out. That's in Tamil actually. I know Tamil, Telugu, Hindi and English. So I've been thinking of which language to go about, and I'm receiving few comments from people, so I thought that I would shoot this in English for all my friends throughout India. So I'd like to thank you guys for patiently listening to me till the end. So I'm gonna close my puja and I'm gonna sign out and say bye guys, and please do subscribe to my channel for more videos, and also do like them and do share them. I mean, you guys know that you have to subscribe to stay connected to me, and I know you would. And also do comment about any other aspects which you are looking out for, which I have probably left out and not covered it. So this was a Pooja Ghar which is having a modern look but yet traditional. So bye guys, I'll catch you in my next video. Bye. Do subscribe, don't forget, okay? Please, yeah.